In the West, water is precious. In Nevada, the last several years of drought severely affected what farmers and ranchers produced. About 100 miles northeast of Reno lies Lovelock, Nevada. Formerly a stop for settlers on their way to California and later a train depot, the town's economy remains based on farming, mining, and some tourism. While almost all of Nevada's counties have been designated as drought disaster areas, this valley, which flood irrigates its fields, has been hardest hit. When fields go fallow, it's not only devastating to landowners, it's devastating to the land. At NRCS, we're here to help landowners find solutions, and Lovelock is a great example. Christy, the NRCS district conservationist in Lovelock, reached out to landowners to offer assistance by way of cover crops. Cover crops are grasses, legumes, and forbs planted for seasonal vegetative cover. At NRCS, this practice is applied to support one or more of the following purposes: to reduce erosion from wind and water, to maintain or increase soil health and organic matter content, to reduce water quality degradation by utilizing excessive soil nutrients, to suppress excessive weed pressures and break pest cycles, to improve soil moisture use efficiency, and to minimize soil compaction.
Last fall, Ronnie came in and he was concerned. He had a bunch of fields due to the drought that were at risk of blowing, and he wanted to incorporate some fertilizer and manure into his soils, but he didn't want to be in non-compliance with his HEL. So he asked me if there was anything that he could do through us or that would help with that. So I took it to our state office and kind of worked with our agronomist and different people there to see what possibly we could help these guys with that have been affected by so many years of drought. And talking with them, we thought cover crop might be a good viable option, and just look at it as if it was a dryland cover crop, because we didn't know if or when we would get water again. So I kind of talked with Ronnie about it, and it's kind of went from there.
We're all flood irrigation, so precipitation doesn't really mean a lot to us unless we can irrigate it. Snow packs everything for us, and storage in the reservoir and stream flows.
In 2013, producers had 0.3 acre feet irrigation allocation. In 2014 and 2015, it was zero. And in 2016, it was just 1 acre foot.
Over that time period, the alfalfa stands have died, and the plant counts were thinning, and we were looking for something to hold the soil in place. I just wanted to keep the soil intact. We have some NRCS contracts, and we have to stay in compliance with highly erodible lands. With plant counts diminishing, we needed something, so planting wheat was just an obvious decision. I told her what I was thinking of doing, wanting to plant some wheat in the fall, hoping that we would get some fall moisture to bring it up so we wouldn't have the soil erosion problems. And she looked into this program and said it was available.
We decided to do winter wheat. It's a common crop grown here in the valley as part of a rotation. With Ronnie, we did a little under 1,200 acres total. And then I had a couple other people decide to do some also.
It was risk. You're just spending money. I mean, you're going out planting it, hoping that it comes up. There's a risk in farming, so that's what it is. But we needed to try to do something. After 3 years with no irrigation on most of these fields, they're just going to blow away.
Well, at first, yeah, it is a big risk because you don't know. You're gambling on whether you're going to get that moisture or not and have the plants germinate. And we were fortunate we got that moisture and it all started sprouting.
We're happy. It actually germinated probably late October, first part of November. We've had the ground covered for since then. I mean, since early December anyway. So we haven't had any issues, and it's green. It's a lot better than looking at dirt like what we've had the last 3 years. I really, really am impressed and happy that we did it.
What do several years of drought and blowing fields look like here in Nevada? Albert Mulder, state agronomist for NRCS Nevada, will show you.
We're sitting here on the edge of a field that has not been irrigated in the last 4 years, going on 5 years. As we see, the upper field you can see bigger aggregates on top and the finer sand starting to move across the field and build up on the edges of the fields. We're starting to see some wind. The wind is starting to move and there's a little bit of residue. These fields are ideal for some kind of cover. We would like to have 30% residue cover on these fields. And if we hit it at the right time, in the fall, put in like a winter wheat, we were able to catch some of that winter moisture. Even though Nevada has a really low precip, we're trying to get some kind of growth out here. As you can see, the soil is starting to move around.
Bob Gibson also lives and farms in Lovelock and was running into the same issue of soil erosion.
I've been farming in Nevada in Lovelock, Nevada for 53 years. And we usually grow wheat or wheat hay, alfalfa and alfalfa seed. That's 90% of my crops. You have to get a little bit ahead to get some of your ground ready to do other things when you do get water, because there's no way you can do all that work at one time. So we were doing some plowing and ripping and lasering, and we decided to plant some wheat for a cover crop for ourselves, just so that the ground didn't blow and we had problems with it, you know, with the dust. Then the planting became available through the NRCS, and I heard about it, and so I talked with the county at the county office level here, and they told me what it consisted of, so that's how I signed up for it.
So did it work for Bob too? Was NRCS 2 for 2 in the gamble for cover crops to work?
I thought it might work if we got enough moisture, but it depends all on the moisture. I mean, if you don't have enough moisture, it's not going to work. But we were lucky last year it did work. About 10 days ago, we had a huge dust storm of like 60 to probably 70 mile an hour winds, and these fields did not blow where we had the plantings in.
It was a super exciting feeling. I wanted to do a little happy dance just because it worked, you know, and the risk paid off for these guys, and we helped them do something that'll benefit their farm and kind of help combat this drought a little bit.
Do your fields resemble the one Albert was talking about? Do you battle soil erosion and want to try to combat it while maintaining your HEL compliance? Maintaining soil health is the key to fostering more productive, profitable, and sustainable farms and ranches, and cover crops is one way to get there. So stop by your local NRCS office to talk about it, or visit our website at www.nv.nrcs.usda.gov.